the church is fake and all of this, and they make more excuses than an absentee school is. But no, the problem is we got to, A, for one, fix the churches that need to be fixed. If you're doing crazy worldly stuff, can the churches stop doing it? But that all churches are doing it. So you don't have an excuse. You can go somewhere and be with somebody. And so somebody can tell you that there is world changing power in you. Y'all ready? Okay, then I believe it. Cool, that's great. Let's read. The Bible says in verse 6, and when they found him not, Jesus ain't going to let you. Anyway, God got your back. He ain't going to let nobody bother you. And no matter who they go get, they can go get the trashiest, filthiest people in the world. They can't touch you. Because the Bible says, and when they found him not, they drew Jason, the servant brother, unto the rulers of the city, crying, these that have turned the world upside down are come hither also. Wait a minute. So what's happening is that one of them went to complain to the rulers of the city and said, those brothers who we've been hearing about, who they've been talking about, that's turned the world upside down, is now come here also. Now, but the question is, how did they turn the world upside down? They went to preach Christ.
Amen. Amen.
They talked about Jesus. That's why you have the power in you. Because if you are a faith-based believer and you love the Lord, and all you got to do is open up your mouth and talk about Jesus.
All right.
The power is in you to change this world. Now, when I say the world, everybody think that means you got to reach out to the masses and this and this. All you need is one other person. Did you know if you change one person, you've changed the world? Because you kept one person from being corrupt in the world.
Oh,
Lord, have mercy. You've got world-changing power in you. You ain't got to have a title. You ain't got to have a microphone. If you got the love of God in you, you can share that with somebody else and spread Jesus Christ. And don't be upset when people don't believe. It's not everybody is going to believe. But it's in you. It is in you. It is there. You don't have to have, I'm the arch this and that, and oh, I can only come on this day. And you ain't got to have no. All you need to know is the death, burial, and resurrection, and what it means to you, and why he did what he did, and how he can do it for somebody. How the Lord changed you for being a filthy rag, and how he can change somebody else. Can we start talking about Jesus, please? I would love to see more news outlets talking about the Lord, but you think they're going to do that? No! Because they want you talking about confusion.
That's right.
But that's why, as believers, we need to not focus on the world. We need to get back to focusing on the Word of God and keep spreading Jesus Christ. And just talk about the Lord. Now, let's put this in context. I'm not telling you to walk out here and you just can't function in life. And Lord, the preacher said I'm going to talk about Jesus. So does that mean in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, this, when you get an opportunity to share the word with somebody, you can talk about the Lord.
Amen.
If you're amongst other believers, I'm sure the Lord is going to come up sometime. I'm sure fried chicken is going to come up sometime. I'm sure barbecues, I'm sure the football game. God ain't upset with you talking about other things, but if you're given the opportunity, spread Jesus Christ. He ain't always walking around here like zombies. Oh, Lord, I can't do anything. No, he didn't make us to act like that. That's a robot. That's a robot. He just wants us to be human. Be a human being. Love the Lord. Love who you are. Just keep on walking. Keep on being faithful. And in the end, you're going to get your reward. But in the process, live life and just talk about Jesus from time to time. Because it's in you to change this world. Just like they was complaining back in those days.
Amen.
They didn't have the internet back in those days. Amen. So how did they know the world was getting turned upside down?
Right.
That's because they started seeing change all around them.
Yeah.
They started seeing people who had been learning something for hundreds of years turn away from that and say, I don't want to do this custom no more. I want to walk after Jesus.
All
right. And they said, boy, that Jesus is turning this world upside down. I told y'all I'm going to say his name 100 times. You don't have to get over it. If this is a faith-based church, you ought to want to hear the name of Jesus.
That's right.
Because without him, we would be nothing.
Amen.
All right. My last point, and I'm out your way, I promise. 8:29, don't worry. I'm almost done. A couple more minutes, and I'll be out your way, and I'll be back tomorrow, and then we can rock a little bit. All right. My fourth point is, there is one Jesus, and that name still drives the devil crazy. That name still drives the devil crazy. That's why he don't want you to like the Lord. Because he knows how awesome Jesus is. He knows how amazing Jesus is. So if he can get you worried about everything else but the Lord, he can get you all confused. But no. Let's read verse 7. Watch this. Whom Jason had received, and these all do contrary to the decrees of Caesar, saying that there is another king, one Jesus. And they troubled the people and the rulers of the city when they heard these things.
Right.
Oh, y'all want to know why politicians and all these people is crazy? Because they don't know the law.
Amen.
Some stuff is just common sense.
Right.
Now, preacher, you can't say that. You don't know their heart. I know their actions. They ain't acting like they know the law. Jesus.
Yeah.
You know why people get so mad when you bring up Jesus? Because he convicts. Jesus convicts.
Yeah.
Jesus wants what's best for your life.
Yeah.
So that means whatever you're doing opposite of the word of God, he's going to try to come on in there and say, look, let's just make some room for me and let's clear out some stuff. We all got some stuff in our closets. Every now and then you need to take inventory of your personal closet and say, wait a minute, I can't wear that no more. Doing me no good. I can't do this no more. I gotta make room for some more Jesus in my life because when I'm full of other things, it's a clutter. Sometimes you just gotta mentally dump yourself, just drain it. Say, look, I just need to focus on Jesus.
Amen.
I'm trying too much, I'm doing too much. Let's just go back to the basics. Because he said in the letters were in red, if I be lifted up, will draw all men unto me. So you don't have to put on a parade for people to come. You don't have to do it. All you gotta do is lift up the name of Jesus. He said, I will then draw all men unto me. Amen. And at that name, it still causes the devil trouble. He gets angry. He gets frustrated when you try to position Jesus higher than anybody else. Isn't it funny? I oftentimes look at Facebook, and I'm about to close. Oftentimes look at Facebook, and I laugh at people because everybody was so upset about who's standing and who's sitting for the flag. Lord, no, you didn't sit down on the flag. No, you didn't. And be the first one to sleep in church. Now, how in the world you mad about the flag, but you sleep in church? Now, maybe I'm wrong, but it sounds like somebody's priorities is a little out of whack. Be the first one cussing somebody out when they cut you off, but you mad about the flag? Man, you better get back to Jesus. I'm going to sit down and close then, because they mad at me. Listen.
Yes, Lord.
Everybody. people hungry every day, but we worried about flight. Are you kidding me? All the drugs and destruction that's being pumped into this world, we worried about the flight. But the devil will use confusion to get you stirred up. Now he got your blood pressure boiled over something you ain't got nothing to do with. That's why people talk to me about politics. They get frustrated. They realize I can care less because I serve the Lord. The world is going to do what the world do. And as the scripture said, Caesar is going to be who Caesar is. And Caesar going to get mad because he's like, wait a minute, I'm the only king here. But there is one king and his name is Jesus. So if you continue to make Jesus the king of your life, you are going to be all right. Amen. I'm done. Put the blessed hands together. Amen. Amen. If you continue to make Jesus Christ the king of your life, quit worrying about everybody else. Your life. I'm trying to stay safe myself. I'm trying to make it myself. But if you can just make Jesus the king of your life and wipe away all these distractions, it's just a distraction, sister. All of these worries of the world, cast all your cares on him. For he first cared for us. And then ask the church. I'm seeing church folks on Facebook arguing with people over the flag. Yeah. Why are you arguing about the flag? I want to know why you were shacking up with that woman's husband.
No, he didn't. Yes, I did.
Because I'm more concerned about your soul than whether somebody's standing or not for the flag. We got to get our houses in order. With the Lord.
Yes.
That's just the type of preacher I am. Because God told me a long time ago, son, when you preach, you get one shot. You get one shot at that moment. You better make sure it's a shot for me and not for you. Because if you don't say what I say you say, then you won't have to. So that's why I find it funny when preachers don't want to preach what the word says, because that's what convicts. It convicts me.
That's right.
It should convict us all. But only not to make us feel bad, but to make us want to love Jesus the more. Amen.
Amen.
We'll love you more. Amen. Will there be? When I say will there be one, I'm asking if there's maybe somebody who your faith has been a little wavering, or maybe you don't know the Lord. Maybe I don't know. But whatever it is, you can come at this time and pray. I did a sermon before at Shiloh, and we was talking and teaching about the altar and coming to the altar. And it's not so much because I'm so great or you so less. It's because you sometimes need somebody to lean on.
Amen.
Somebody who's a like-minded believer to pray with you and talk with you. Amen.
Amen.
Will there be one? It can be about any issue. You can touch and agree and pray on that thing. But God will be there in the midst. Will there be one? Amen. Put them blessed hands together for a whole house. Amen. I guess I'll be back tomorrow if the Lord is willing. We'll talk about some more exciting things. Amen. At this time, we're there. All right. Well, I'm actually standing to your feet. We'll go on and close out. Amen. I like that, man. Come up. Get it going.